This trip is part 8 of 10 in the ATS Gold Rush Challenge. Deliver 10 loads to or from the NAMIQ company at the gold mines in Colorado. Our driver starts with his Freightliner Cascadia at the gold mine off the unsealed road up to Yankee Boy Basin. He has a load of gravel and is ready to go by 0014. He leaves the mine and makes his way to the road down the canyon. This is a challenge in the dark, as is the $1 million highway section of the US 550 to Durango after that. It is a slow drive, and once he gets to Durango, he finds he is quite tired. After 3 tickets in 5 minutes, he goes to a rest spot and parks up at 0520. He wakes at 1520, needing to drive the rest of the way to the Kingman district without a sleep. This is a challenge as he plans to divert through Monument Valley. So from Durango, it is along the US 160 to Cortez, then the US 491 to Monticello, then the US 191 past Bluff, then the US 163 to Monument Valley through Mexican Hut. I was hoping our driver could reach the viewpoint near the Arizona border before dark, but that didn't happen. So while he had a brief rest, our view is dark and limited. He moves on to Kayenta and on to the US 160. This goes southwest to US 89, which he took south to Flagstaff. Here he got onto the US 40 past Ash Fork to the Seligman turnoff. Here he gets onto Route 66, northwest, then southwest past Peach Springs. As the road gets closer to Kingman, he comes to some roadworks that turn out to be the destination for his gravel load. He auto parks 4 minutes late. Alrighty. Let's get going.
Ready to roll.
Let's see if we can go out this way. This is NAMIQ facilities in Yankee Boy Basin. If you wanted to know where it was. Smoothly enough. Now we've got to exit the facility and drop down the basin to the main road. Intersection intersecting unsealed roads. Can be a bit rough. Certain North American mines and quarries. Traffic. This area does have a reasonable number of summertime visitors. high beam can only do so much. A bit of road back there was cut out of the rock. So there's a bit of an overhang. Showing you that. So dark you wouldn't see anything. We're coming down to Durango. Which is a 6512 feet. Need to divert to another side of town to have a rest.
Go straight. Go straight. Go straight. Stay right, then turn right. Turn right.
Give me a right turn, then right.
Go straight. Go straight. Go straight. Stay left, and then turn left. turn left.
Durango is being very slow for me.
Go straight, and then turn right. Turn right. Please make a U-turn when possible.
Okay, mid-afternoon. We're ready to go again. Well, refuel seem to be blocking tarmac for most of the day. Okay, so we're in Durango, and that is, I don't know, Trafalgar somewhere, something. And then we're going to go this bit of the 491, see if I haven't been there, down through there. And it's just a really standard way down to Kingman.
Go straight. Stay left, and then turn left. Turn left.
I'm starting to get out of here. says it is. Don't need to go through the weigh station. So we're just going to go from this side of the road.
Go straight.
Not this side road, next one.
Stay right, and then turn right.
Here we are at the junction 491.
Turn right.
This is where we turn onto New Road.
Straight.
Monticello. Here we are. Not a destination place, but a place nonetheless.
Go straight.
So you can rest and refuel if you need to.
Stay left, and then turn left. Turn left. Stay right.
turned south here, but we continue. Through Monument Valley. On US 163. Mexican Heart. Where is this blasted viewpoint? Just over the border.
Straight.
But we'll see what we can see. The world's greatest outdoor museum, Utah Canyon Country. The Monument Valley. Welcome to Utah, life elevated. I'm sure things would look a lot better in daylight. Still.
Get ready to turn right. Turn right. straight.
Wishing my luck again. We are on part of Route 66.
Go straight. Stay right, and then exit right. Exit right. Thank you.
millimeters remaining. Goldrush 8 out of 10. We're late. 4 minutes late. We lost $192 in 8 XP. But we did get 34,450.